appreciate your name, number, I'll call you back to you. Bye!
Let me call you, sweetheart. I'm in love with you.
Hi, reach 467-8446. We can't come to the phone right now because we're getting ready for Valentine's Day. Leave your name, number, time, call, get back to you. Bye! Happy Valentine's Day! Bye!
Happy Valentine's Day! Bye!
What's your name? Kate.
Katie, you don't know your daughter's name.
Get back there.
What'd you say?
Get back there, please. All right, get back there, you fool. I bought you this dress when you were only 6 months old.
You damn
fool. Finally, bitch, I got an expect. For $5.95. Go back. I want to get the outfit. Hurry up. I waited so long for you to wear it. Hey, take the hat off.
Oh, I don't like it.
Go back over there.
My hair's a mess. Oh, no. You don't want to video me at my hair, man.
You getting a haircut today?
No. Ready?
Yeah.
Here I go. Mommy, look. It's snowing.
Be careful, I got the camera.
Wait a minute. Oh. Watch,
Mom. Wow. Go do it again, Kate. Jim? This is our thank you to Stephen, Terry, Stephanie, and Stephen Kasperzak. All the good things they do for us. Giving us good skates.
Hmm. Oh, good ear. I'm ear. I'm ear. All around. See it? Isn't it beautiful?
All right, what's tonight?
The big night!
Melinda, you're not.
Do this, Tim.
I can't get you, Kate, because you moved
move
up frontwards.
Back up. Get off, please. Watch.
Jim, back up. I can't get the scene because I'm too close. That's it.
Whoa, don't hit me.
Kate, let me see you.
Thank you. Yeah. Can't you tell?
The shop is lost, tight and every beat. pictures, and television are gathering for the party of the year.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, everybody's going wild, there's a car's arrived, bringing big stars, there's also many, the greatest names of the new millennium.
I'll enjoy it so much, right down to the chewy chocolate center. Thank you.
My career must be slipping. This is the first time I've ever been available to pick up an award.
I want to thank my fellow nominees.
Barbara and I share the same birthday. We go way, way back. We've been friends for many, many years. We go way, 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 way back to the Garden of Eden. Barbara, you were not the first person to play a boy. I was Adam. But you were there. You were God. Barbara's career began at some time whenever this teleprompter would begin. And then I would tell you it was sometime in 1950, whatever. I saw her in The Blue Angel, and she was no angel. I was. Where is it, guys? Thank you. After God. This won't happen to you. It better not happen to her, guys. In her career, someone asked Barbara Streisand to describe herself. She said, "I am an actress who can sing." I think tonight we will see that we're going to discover that Barbara left out a few minor details. For instance, in 1964, when she was a smash playing singer-comedian Fanny Brice in the Broadway musical Funny Girl, CBS soon signed her to star in her first television special, where she introduced herself to America with these words. And this classic song.
Happy night, happy days. I hear
again. In 1968, Barbara's film debut as Fanny Brice earned her an Oscar and her first of a record 10 Golden Globes. Barbara's role as Dolly Levi helped her win her first Golden Globe for World Film Favorite when she performed one of the most celebrated title songs in Hollywood musical history. Next, Barbara turns to a comedy in a big way when she portrays a rather noisy lady of the evening, George Siegel's meek book clerk, who in this scene can't tell a book by its cover.
What's the matter?
You expecting company?
This happens to be a very expensive creation, you know. I had to send away for it.
Did it come in a plain brown wrapper?
It's one of my modeling outfits.
For whom do you model? The Boston Strangler?
Listen, Mr. Sherman, if you're nice, I'll let you try it on sometime.
All right, let's get one thing straight. Doris.
How do you know my name?
It's written there.
Who gave you permission to read my panties?
In What's Up, Doc, Barbara tries to get absent-minded musicologist Ryan O'Neill to fall for her. Try a couple who are very much in love, but whose basic differences tear them apart.
To be better. I want us to be better. I want you to be better. Sure, I make waves. I mean, you have to, and I'll keep making them until you're every wonderful thing you should be and will be. You'll never find anyone as good for you as I am, to believe in you as much as I do or love you as much.
I know that.
Well, then why?
Do you think if I come back, it's going to be okay by magic? What's going to be changed? What's going to be different? We'll both be wrong. We'll both lose.
Couldn't we both win?
Barbara received her second Golden Globe for the Best Actress and her first producer with her remake of the musical drama A Star Is Born, playing opposite Kris Kristofferson.
Protect yourself, or I'll kill you! I'll kill you! I'll kill you! I'll kill you!
And with every Rain, Barbara becomes the first female composer ever to win a Golden Globe and an Academy Award for Best Song. Barbara made motion picture history and proved to be a champion of women everywhere when she became the first woman to produce, direct, co-write, star, and sing the songs in a film. If she could have cooked, she would have been the caterer. She took home the Golden Globe for Best Picture as well as Best Director when she gave us this tale of a young woman who was forced to masquerade as a boy in order to study the Torah.
Can you hear me? Papa, can you see me? Papa, can you find me in the night?
Why didn't you tell me you were a woman?
I was afraid.
Of what?
Of this and exactly that.
So you lied to me. You lied to a ghost. God, things I told you, things I wouldn't even tell a wife.
I'm glad you told me.
What kind of a creature am I?
Just a woman.
It's not good enough. I want the answer. Tell me the answer. Why? Why?
Barbara gives one of the most powerful performances of her career as an explosive woman who is trying to convince us that she is not nuts.
Another picture in your heads, Claudia the Nut! You get what I'm telling you? Now, he can sign a piece of paper saying I'm nuts, but it's only a piece of paper. And you can't make me nuts that way, no matter how many times you sign it. No matter how many times you say it, you can't make me nuts. Why, you, Mama? I'm just getting straight, all of you. I won't be nuts for you.
Barbara became the third woman ever to be nominated as Best Director by the Directors Guild of America for her work on a film about a Southern man played by Nick Nolte confronting childhood trauma and the pain that that caused.
Let yourself feel it. It takes courage to feel pain, Tom. You can do it. You can handle it. Don't be afraid. It's okay.
Jeff Bridges are two people with almost nothing in common but love. You can sing. No, you didn't tell us that with 42 gold, 26 platinum, 13 multi-platinum albums. You are the highest selling female recording artist ever. You are shy. So, Barbara, my friend, you are one of the real ones. You are a universe into yourself. Since we were born on the same day and we've tried to spend most of our birthdays together, I think I know what it is to be a Taurus. A Taurus means that your directness is the very spine of your honest personality. Now, your honesty is your truth, to be sure, but you feel it with such incandescent insight whenever you are truthful that you help to actually redefine any given moment. You have fascinated me since I first saw you at the Coconut Grove. I don't remember what year. It was in your West Coast debut. And I was 25 and you were 18. And I remember that you went on late because your hair wasn't dry. Remember that? And then when you finally appeared in that little navy blue midi blouse and your mini skirt, I was aware when I first saw you that I was looking at and hearing a gift from God. She is very attracted to sensual specifics that most people overlook. For example, she will notice if you are wearing a new perfume and she will know the name of it. She will notice if someone has just had a tooth capped. She feels compelled to express perfection and feels very depressed when other people don't live up to the potential of their own brilliance. You have taste, you have humor, you have exceptional timing. And as a friend, I deeply appreciate the sensitivity that you have for the opinions of others. You are unceasingly interesting, extremely challenging. You are a sponge when it comes to learning, motivated almost entirely by your artistic and velvet obsession with detail. You are an artist unparalleled, and I absolutely adore what you have done with your life. You have been entertaining us now for nearly four decades, and who would have known when you sang that song in Funny Girl about being the greatest star that you would sing such prophetic lyrics in that you are the greatest star of this or any other millennium, and I was there for all of them, so congratulations.
Someone blows it.
you. God, to watch a film like that, it's what a great business. You get to age publicly, right? It's really nice getting awards, but somebody's cell phone just rang. Isn't it terrible? Wow. It's great getting awards, but it's difficult knowing just what to say. You know, just what to say, because there's so many things you could talk about. But anyway, this is heavy. You see? Good ears. Someone asked me recently if they should be an actor. And I said, if you have to ask, then the answer is no. Because the only reason to choose that life for yourself is because you feel passionate about it. Because you have no other choice. I wanted to be an actress ever since I can remember. But I was very skinny. The only time I liked the way I looked was in the reflection of a hubcap. Do you remember those old, the old round hubcaps? You know, they made you look fatter. Like a camera, they added 10 pounds. Anyway, nowadays they have very strange hubcaps. Have you noticed? You can't see yourself in them. And, you know, how are you supposed to check yourself out? So. Anyway. In high school, so I can tell how old you all are, the hubcaps. In high school, I was a misfit. I was an honor student, and yet I had streaked hair, and I wore purple lipstick. And as a way of escaping reality, I hid out a lot at a nearby theater that showed these wonderful movies with subtitles. It was an art house, but at the time, I didn't know what that was. I just know that, I mean, now I know that those monochromatic frames, those black and white images that I later realized were made by Kurosawa and other great foreign directors would resonate for me many, many years later. At the time, I was going to two different acting teachers. I didn't want to miss anything. And what I observed in those classes was that people were much more interesting when they weren't trying to act, when they were doing nothing but a simple relaxation exercise. Just the tiniest twitch of an eyebrow became fascinating. I guess just being human, you know? It was the something in the doing nothing, the truth of the moment that was so powerful to me. And now here I am, several decades later, receiving the Cecil B. DeMille Award. I never worked with Mr. DeMille, but I was fortunate to have another cinematic giant as my first director. William Wyler, whom I adored, was a brilliant, brilliant storyteller. And Willie knew the truth when he saw it. And his willingness to listen to, feels like a baby, he and I hold a baby. His willingness to listen to this neophyte's ideas made me want to please him even more. And one of my prized possessions is a megaphone that Willie gave me at the end of shooting Funny Girl, which still sits on my desk. He wanted to encourage me to direct at the time. Someday. Anyway, when I was preparing to direct my first film, I couldn't wait to speak to Willie. We planned to meet when I got back from a location scout. But unfortunately, Willie passed away before I returned, and we never got to have that talk. But his wife, Tally, wrote me a beautiful letter that said, if you're ever on the set and you don't know what to do, be very still. And you'll hear Willie whispering in your ear. Believe me, I heard him many times. What I love about directing is the learning process, the research, the details, the challenge of how to tell a story, how to serve the actors who have entrusted themselves to you. how to create an atmosphere where the actor is free to bare his soul and reveal his own truth. I'm drawn to subjects that celebrate life and the resilience of the human spirit. I love films that make us care about a little mouse in The Green Mile that we just saw recently, or Reuben Carter's unjust prison sentence. The beauty of art is that it can show humanity to itself. I know this has been said many times, but it is a privilege to be able to work at something you feel passionate about. And I'm deeply grateful to the members of the Hollywood Foreign Press Association who've been so generous in acknowledging my work from the very beginning of my career. Thank you for your continued support and this most wonderful tribute. I'm also grateful to the many people who've shared my passion for the details. Joe Layton, who did my first, my earliest TV specials. Harry Stradling, who photographed my first four pictures. Sidney Pollack, I don't know where you are, but who directed The Way We Were. And and so many other wonderful record producers, songwriters, Harold Arlen, Julie Stein, Stephen Sondheim, Marilyn and Alan Bergman, Marvin Hamlisch, screenwriters, costume and production people, hairdressers, orchestrators, and my husband Jim, who keeps my passion alive and who doesn't mind that I'm not so skinny anymore, right? My last thought of the evening, awards. In researching some of the songs that I just sang on New Year's Eve, I was surprised to find out that some of our greatest standards never won an Academy Award. As a matter of fact, they were never even nominated. Like A Foggy Day, I'm in the Mood for Love, Someday My Prince Will Come. And there were many movies that were never nominated, like The African Queen, Singing in the Rain, 2001, Close Encounters, which you actually just showed Jim's little daughter last night. And I thought to myself, it doesn't matter, really, how many awards something received. What matters is, did it stand the test of time? Did it touch people's lives? Can you remember where you were when you first heard that song or saw that movie? Who were you with? Did you laugh or cry? What was going on in your life at the time? Was it at the end of a love affair or the beginning of a marriage? Does it bring back memories when you hear or see it today? The truth is, when it comes to awards, I'm not certain anyone remembers from year to year who won or didn't win. They remember the work, not the validation of the work. So, if by next year you've all forgotten that I received this award, I promise you I'll understand, and I'll always have this to remind me of this very special honor. Thank you.
Who will win the Golden Globe? Annette Bening, Julianne Moore, Meryl Streep, Hilary Swank, or...
This community meeting today.
The second one. I had to do it in front of the fifth graders.
And the kindergartens.
Be watching. Hey, well, I'm so glad that you came up to my end. Who's that? It's your father? Does he want you? Go play with a friend, Dusty. People, you can wake him up, you can say, get up! And that's like, not nice, and ruins everybody's day. Kids never wake up if you say that to them anyway. Or you can say, but when you wake up the suitcase, you have to do it in your nicest voice. You have to say, good morning. I mean, really nice. So he wakes up. Okay, you ready? Shall we try? One, two, three.
Good morning.
Okay. Good job. Okay. Well, I got lots of puppets in here. How many people ever made here? That little thing? That's not
no,
big. Now, I want you to think.
Is he?
Yeah. Really big. Your job, when Mr. Punch says, I'm going to hit him with my stick, because that's the way you do it. Your job is to say, no, that's not the way you do it. Okay? That's your job. Let's practice. I'm going to hit him with my stick, because that's the way you do it. No, that's not the way you do it. Well, yeah, sheep. Yeah, what's a sheep? A sheep.
He's cute. Gonna pop?
With a bee on his knee. Well, I gave him a rose. He stuck it on his nose. So then I got a giraffe and a half of the rat in his hat, the cute in a suit with a rose on the nose and a bee on his knee. Well, I gave him a shoe. Can you put this shoe on him? Put it right on this foot. So now I got a giraffe and a half of the rat in his hat, the cute in a suit with a rose and nose, a bee on his knee, and some glue on his shoe. Then I gave him a chair, and he tried combing his hair. So he got a giraffe and a half of the rat in his hat, the cuteness with a rose nose, a bee on his knee, and some glue in his shoe, and a chair in his hair. Well, I gave him a flute, and I taught him to toot. So can you say this with me? I got a giraffe and a with a rat in his hat, looking cute in a suit, with a rose on his nose, and a bee on his knee, and some glue on his shoe, and a chair in his hair, and a flute he could toot. And I gave him a bike, and he ran over a spike. So now I got a giraffe and a half of the rat in a satin, a cute in a suit with a rose nose, a bee on his knee, and a glue in a shoe, and a chair in his hat. Thought you were saying it with me. Too fast. Oh, okay. And a bike with a spike, and along came a snake. Uh-oh. That's all stuck to other things. That was eating a cake. So now I've got a giraffe and a with a rat in his hat, looking cute
in a suit,
with a rose on his
nose,
and a bee on his
knee,
and some glue on his
shoe,
and a chair in his
hair,
and a flute he could
toot,
and a bike with a
spike,
and a snake eating
cake,
and along came a skunk.
Oh, no.
Lived in a trunk with smelly parts. So now I got a giraffe and a half of the rat and sound of a cute to see with a rose and nose, the bee on his knee, and some glue in his shoe, and a chair in his hair, and a pretty cute, a bite, a spike, a snake, and taking a skunk. And along came a dragon. It was sitting in a wagon. Somebody always tells me it looks like Barney, but it's a giraffe. We got a giraffe and a with a rat in his looking cute
in his suit,
with a rose on his nose and a bee on his
feet,
and some glue on his
shoe,
and a chair
and his
hair, and a flute he could
do,
and a bite with a
spike,
a snake eating
cake,
and a skunk
in
a and Barney in a
wagon
and a wagon, and along came a whale and bit him on the tail.
That hurt.
So we got a giraffe and a half of the rat and a silent cute sit with a rose nose, a bee on his knee, and a glue in his shoe, and a chair in his ear, and a fleek suit, bite his back, a snake in his tail, skunk in a trunk, a dragon in a wagon, a whale on his tail. He fell in a hole that was dug by a mole. But if we gave him a pole to climb out of the hole, and the whale on his tail ran off with a mail, and the dragon, Barney, the dragon ran off because his wagon was sagging. And we sold the skunk in the trunk to a man that bought junk. And the snake with a cake ran off and jumped in the lake. And the bee on his knee flew off with a flea. And we gave the chair to a tired old bear. And he gave the bike with a spike to a scout on a hike. And he sold the flute he could toot to a band for some fruit. And he took the shoe, he took the shoe with the glue. He put it on you. And he threw the suit that looked cute down the laundry chute. And he gave the rose on his nose to a girl that he chose. And the silly old rat ran off with a hat. And we shrunk him by half, we'd have a giraffe. And that's the story of the giraffe. Okay, now, we've been working all week on these tricks. And she's going to jump through this hoop, okay? So are you paying attention? Okay, you're going to jump through the hoop. Okay.
Now, have attention.
Pay attention. Okay, you're going to jump through the hoop. Okay. Stop it. Do you want to go to timeout? Okay, now, you're jump through the hoop. Or you promise. Okay. You want the children to count. Okay, you have to count to three. And then you jump. Okay, on the count of three, she's going to jump. Ready? One, two, three. You weren't paying attention. You were not paying attention. Do you want popcorn? Well, you won't get any popcorn unless you pay attention. I don't care what you do. There's no popcorn. Oh, they're not going to give you popcorn either. Okay? You want it closer.
Yes.
Okay, how's that? Okay, you're going to do it this time? You promise. Okay. Yes, they'll count again. You ready?
One, two, three.
That's not funny. Well, you think it's funny. Well, you better do it right, or there will be no popcorn.
At all.
Ever.
Yeah. All right.
So here we go. You want it closer. Okay, how's that? Okay. You ready? Yes, they'll count again. Here we go. Ready?
One, two, three.
Well, that's about all we could do this week. So I...
Here. Had a fun day in the snow, huh?
Yep. I'm smoking a pipe. I'm Frosty the Snowman.
Hey, Frosty the Snowman.
I am too. See, lift my arm.
Hey, little bud.
I'm Frosty the Snowman.
Do you remember me putting sheets out and drying it all over the bed? So big.
Oh.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Ready, set, go. Hey, now, relax, set, go, show on, go, play. Hey, now, relax, set, go, show on, go, play.
Is it in sync or anything, or you don't know?
I don't know that.
I'll tell you the words, you sing it.
I don't have to.
Kate, shut the light over there.
I knew she was going to come back.
I can't do it, Daddy. I'll go shut the other way. Wait. It's going to be so dark.
Are you filming that much dark?
Right now I could get it. If I have a night shot, I can do it too. Oh, I see.
Okay, wait.
Now, Jim, do your parents come to the show?
Yeah. Yeah.
My parents don't like her.
Do you like her? Excuse me. Do your parents like the show, Jim?
A lot. More than hers.
Yeah? Okay, I just have one more very serious question.
What?
Are you two sweethearts or just business partners?
Business.
I'm about to
fix
this.
I have a question. The fire department man, because they see his little patch on his arm.
Yeah, you have a question, man. You have any questions?
No questions.
You
have any questions? Tell me now. Did the snow stop? Oh my God. The snow is starting in 1 minute.
Yeah, stop. Come on.
You with the blue short. You with the video camera.
You guys know how to sing. Do
you
dance?
You with the video camera. You with the blue short. You with the video camera. You with the brown sweater.
I have a question.
Okay.
Are you going to dance during this segment?
No, she might. I might go.
Oh, we would love you to dance. What do we do to make you dance? Do we clap? What do we do?
Yeah, you got to clap a lot.
Okay.
Very hard to.
Okay.
Ready? Okay. I'm telling you when to clap.
Okay.
Show is now starting. Curtains.
No. Okay. You have to ask her the names. What's yours?
Jim.
What's yours?
Kim.
What's yours?
Luana.
What's yours?
Nana.
What's yours?
Kim.
What's yours? Oh, she's making a bigger audience.
Yeah.
Okay. Woo! Okay, don't open the curtain yet, Mr. Stone.
I'm her assistant. I do most of it. Okay. She just sits there and laughs.
Did you hear me? Okay, sorry, folks. I'm right there. Don't open the curtain, Mr. Jimmy. And you too, Big Jim, and you too, Kim, and you too, Nana, whatever your name is. Okay, what's your name? I don't know, I am Stark! Thank you for this, Stark, it's my sweetheart. Oh, don't do that. Yes, I have a little surprise for everyone in the audience.
That's Rose O'Donnell. She's getting everything from all the shows.
This is for you.
That's why I like it.
For me, it's beautiful.
I know. My Kim loves Rosie.
It's on.
Okay, good. Yeah.
Can I do this one, Kate?
Don't do it. And I didn't open this. I'm trying to shut it. But he goes trying to open this. Okay. Don't touch. I changed my video camera. I'm going to play speaker. Oh my God! That means that I don't do that. You hurt my earrings. Now I'm going to go. I'm going to my room. Okay. Our show is starting right now. I'm opening the curtains because it's my room. No closing or anything. Keeping it like this, no moving.
No, you have to move this one.
No?
You have to move this one, they can't see.
It's starting right now.
Ready?
Okay, our first show would be me and this music. Can you move over? Give me, please. Okay.
The microphone, Kate, because you're getting tangled
Thank
in that.
Jim, help your sister, honey. Oh, she got it.
Got it?
Sing a
song. Who likes Walt Disney?
Sing a song you know.
Who likes Walt Disney?
I
we
do.
All do.
What?
This is not our car, our van. The key, they couldn't find the key, and they let us borrow this for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, half a Monday. We're getting ours today on Valentine's Day. It was nice driving it.
Let me call you, sweetheart. I'm in love with you. Hi, reach 467-8446. We can't come to the phone right now because we're getting ready for Valentine's Day. Leave a name, number, time, call, get back to you. Bye!
Happy Valentine's Day! Bye!
Happy Valentine's Day! Bye! Hi, reach 467-8446. We can't come to the phone right now because we're looking for a pot of gold. Leave your name, number, time, call, get back to you. Happy St. Patrick's Day!
Happy St. Patrick's Day! Bye!
What are we doing?
Major George Washington. Cherry trees.
Is mine okay?
I can never tell a lie.
If I do, I'll never be a president again.
You putting the cherries on your tree?
Yep.
Like George Washington.
I will never tell a lie. I will never be a president again. That's what Katie said.
What?
He said, I will never tell a lie, or I will never be a president again.
And who was our first president?
George Washington.
And who taught you that, Kate?
He was born rich. George Washington was born rich. He was born rich.
No, he wasn't. Until he had to come around with scissors and cut the lip.
Kate.
Hey! Hello.
Move out of my way, Buster.
Hello.
Hello.
Get a cherry tree.
How do I like my soup?
Get your job done.
Get my job done.
Let me see your pictures. How's it coming?
Hey,
nice and neat?
It's locked.
Oh, you're doing nice. Okay, Jimmy Fish, what is it?
It's a cherry tree, and he cut it down.
But he could not tell a lie. Mm-hmm.
First, you break them in half, you crunch them up, and you put them on. And there's George Washington's apple tree.
Not an apple tree.
Strawberries?
What?
Strawberries?
No.
I give up.
What do you love to eat on ice cream?
Chocolate.
Cherries.
That's it. Cherry tree. What is it?
Cherry tree. I said it right. You know. Hold on. Hey. Shh. Oopsie. Oops, I almost put it in my mouth. It would be very... oopsie. You clench it up. Get it real tiny, see? See it? I'll get it close up. See? And now, go there. Trying to find the littlest. Hi. Okay. Now I'll show you how to make the cherry tree. Now, it's not my last drawer, okay? Okay, see? You whip it in half. Then you clench it up. Okay? I like that. That's my favorite thing. You clench it up. And see, there's one more frill. So I stick it on. And there's my apple tree. How's it look?
Looks good.
I'm glad it looks
good. Your apple tree?
Yeah. No, my cherry. Get it up close, Ma.
Kate, what are we doing today? Where are we? Go near that snow, so see how tall it is. Kate. All right, turn around, guys. Come back. Come back this way.
That's the good part. There's so much snow, you gotta really go somewhere.
Yeah.
Hit or wreck something. I mean.
Oh, yeah. Is this him coming?
Yeah.
He sounds little.
That's him.
Right, I told you. That's safe. It doesn't go over 30. You'll never get hurt.
There comes Jerry.
He hit the kill. Yep.
Adam, I think we can go home to this place. What are you talking about? The sled don't work anymore. I'm out of here.
Same spot.
The king is moving something.
Just got done
better than you.
Yeah. You must have just got done a play right here. Yeah. Horses are all
wet. Oh,
yeah. Oh, this is so nice. Oh.
Hold on, man.
Oh, did you lose anything?
Hey, no. Woo!
I got it.
I got it. Jimmy?
This ride's about to start.
Jim, you want to sit on the floor?
I don't want to die. Let's sit on the floor then.
Sit right on the floor.
Santa Fe.
Santa Fe.
What do you want us to say?
The day of a fun is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey!
Woo!
Okay, hon, let's open up a restaurant in Santa Fe.
Let's open up a restaurant in Santa Fe. Oh,
that'll record in the dark like this?
It's got a night shot on it. It does infrared.
Oh, that's yeah. Nice. Can I borrow that? Can I borrow that?
Yeah, I'll watch.
I just want to show them that it's a sleigh.
I think they know
about it. And what's that? Whoa. Well, it's a sleigh.
That's the snow. That's the
they usually lose one foot.
Oh, it's not going to be busy. It's not going to be busy.
It's not
going to
be busy. We'll see here.
Well, too bad she didn't leave in the snow.
That
was all annoying. Ding dong, the witch is there. Wicked witch is there.
Get KK.
One of us is dead!
Say hi to Grandma on the video.
Say hi, Nana.
Hey, look at yourself.
Say hi.
Are you warming up?
Tell her what you did today.
What'd you do today?
We're gonna die! We're gonna die! We're gonna die!
Tell her how you went on the big snow mound. Whoa.
What's it called again?
We could've brought you a little skidoo, put it right in here.
The black hole.
Good idea.
We could have all rode back.
You want me to get you, Jim?
I'll go first. You go first with
I'll take you and your wife. You know?
Yeah, but you brought us too big.
Come on. I can't give a kiss on the sleigh right now.
Jenny, you were saying how good you were. That was pretty cheap.
Yeah, see?
Oh, what do you want to hear, Frank?
Whatever you got in you.
What I got in me.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Oh. Get in the hat down.
Catapult. E-I-E-I-O.
See, there's the syrup line.
Where?
Right here.
Is that one of the chefs?
And on this farm we had some people that said, help me.
Is that one of the sugar chefs?
That's one of the storage
homes. Help!
Can I take a picture or scare the horses?
Absolutely. No, I think you could take a picture.
A flash.
You better ask.
Phil asked if he could take pictures.
No, we could. Yeah.
Ask him. I think he said he could. Then.
Maybe you got to choke it a little.
He's been hi.
And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Hey!
It does.
No. No, that's in the middle of it.
Oh.
All right, we got to change the song.
Two eyes made out of coal.
Hey!
Frosty the Snowman.
Hey, my friend.
You know that song?
That's a friend.
Oh, keep shining. Hey,
look at it.
Oh, yeah, I know that one.
No kids
go
off.
The ride is still young.
Go to kindergarten and that's it. What'd you call it? A thunderstorm? What'd you say?
An avalanche.
But she called it something else today.
What?
I thought he said I've got a bad reputation up here.
Why am I not sitting next to her then?
Anybody you want looking at?
What do you want?
There's beavers in there. Beavers.
Are they?
Yeah. Well, keep
all right,
going.
Can I go and videotape them? These are land beavers?
Yeah, all summer. They pick
put
all
the night shot out of it.
What do they do all summer?
I'm like a beaver, too.
You kind of look like one, too.
Not water, land beavers. You got two kind of beavers.
And they're in here, huh?
They're in there.
What kinds of beavers?
Land beavers.
They're land beavers.
Land beavers? They got two legs or four?
They got four legs.
Four legs?
Trees.
These horses are going to get us killed. They're going to get us killed.
Nah, they love that. That's what they live for, those horses. Those horses live for that.
Oh, I know, but see, there's a sharp line.
Right there. Oh, yeah.
You go right by your finger house, huh?
Oh, yeah. Then we're going to make a tour to the Derby, and then we're going to stop at McDonald's.
Oh, my God.
We're going to stop at McDonald's, too? Okay, you're going to have French fries.
We're going to make it to Mr. LeBlanc tonight.
We should have left that car on 91.
Yeah. We're going to pick you up right there.
That's right.
See? They put them out.
Whoa. Oh.
Yeah, they put them out.
Behave.
You know what? All during Christmas when we didn't have no snow, kept losing his toenails.
Ice 24.
He fell off in the road. Yeah. So we tie him right there to show the kids. Toenail, Bigfoot.
Yeah. Bigfoot toenails.
Ice 24.
I had a girl like that one time. Toenails just like that.
Okay. Shit, man.
He's well, just like.
<I'm not praying. laughs>
Look at those trees, all that stuff.
Where's that dog?
You guys gotta fake it too.
I made that last summer.
On silvery moon.
All three. You gotta do all three.
All three.
If you're happy, you know it.
If you're happy and you know it, do all three.
Hooray!
If you're happy and you know it, do all three.
Hooray! If you're happy and you know it, and you really, really show it. If you're happy and you know it, do all three. Hooray!
If there were 10 bottles of beer, I know what.
Lumber. That's lumber.
Lumber?
Lumber behind you, lumber. All the snow.
Oh, in there, there's a hermit.
Dead bodies?
A hermit. We thought he was dead.
I was crushing too. She was crushing.
Oh, yeah,
we were right there.
Beatles, like friends.
If you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeers used to laugh and draw him names. For Rudolph, join any reindeer games.
Where do we know this song?
Then one foggy Christmas Eve, you know Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
Hey, that was one of our best. How's that clean?
One of our better tunes.
What happened? The guy died, and that stone stopped on the tree. And if you look in the back, last year we could see his skull. We put a little more dirt on it, right there. That's a long time ago. Kids got scared, so we put a little more dirt on them. Mm-hmm. That's what happens. We still tapping that tree.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, a little soap out of it.
Yeah.
If you eat too much sugar on the snow, it's just your belly's gonna be hard rock maple.
My belly's hard rock maple now.
Uh-oh, you were afraid I'm not one.
That's weird. Look at all these cool things on the right. It's cool. 200 years
ago. It flooded.
It didn't fall apart.
It flooded.
Make today. Let's get up and get away.
You go, Laura. You know all this.
Oh, I know.
Rest area.
Oh, you do it. One foot on the seat, the other one on top.
Couples
are three. Couples three. Couple three. There you go. Couldn't you
want to take a shot at it?
Sure, let's go for it. It's free. What do we got to lose? Okay, who's going to jump off?
You
jump first. You jump first.
Somebody's going to have to guide me.
Couples are free because there's a video hooked up to the internet in there.
Hey, I smell something. I think the last guy forgot to flush.
Hey, look at the key. Head probably the key. Yeah, look how rounded that is. No, but that's why.
Okay, cover your ears. Can you?
What's the reason for keeping it in there?
That's why we make a little brandy, a little syrup.
What's the time? Can you even go through there? You got a lot of shoveling to do?
Well, the tractor's going to do part of that.
Yeah.
It'll take too long. We need a bulb. Okay, what's them chain for up here? Those three chains.
What are they for?
What? Yeah.
For towing my car. On a tow truck.
Logging?
No. They made them chain for a reason.
Tie your wife up.
Look at the
There's three of them.
So the three wives.
Somebody should know.
Trees.
Oh, no.
I bet you Jock knows.
I can tell you what the snowshoes are for.
Jock?
Oh.
It's to choke up on something.
Jock should know.
Jock?
Are they old binders?
No.
Oh.
Choke up on something.
Is that your final answer?
They're sled brakes.
Are they
you
really?
You work in the mountain there, you load a big little log.
Yeah.
Put them on your... a lot of bad hill and corners, you can put one brake or three brakes.
On your runner. Four. You put them on your runner.
And the runner's on a...
Things have flashed.
We just carry the snow in. We carried your dessert.
Yeah, I saw that.
My donuts kind of got burnt in the bottom because I forgot them. I was trying to warm them up for you.
Anna, you want a cocoa?
Where'd you go?
No, you're fine.
You're in the picture.
No way, ho!
Do it.
I got it. What do? You wrap?
Wrap it. Puts it on the snow and it cools down.
Oh, I'm sorry, Frank.
It's all right.
Frank, yeah. You let us take the snow scoot out here in the fall.
Yeah.
That was so cool.
She's in a fall.
Yeah, well, we're eating.
Let me see, hon.
Can we start eating?
It's good.
Delicious.
Come over down here.
Go get a fork over there on the table.
Here, Kate.
Called sugar on snow. What do you think? Think you like it?
They say syrup here. We say syrup. Syrup.
It looks just like a wet bike with a track on it. It's about as big as a max little quad.
but it's called a snow scoop. Yamaha used to make them. They stopped making them. It's so cool. She just wrote it too. It's little. Like, it whips all around.
They're like, oh, take that.
Oh, they got
it?
Yeah.
They got it out?
I got to give them my name. Same thing.
Jimmy, go all the way around and look up in the sky for me.
Pretty wild, aren't you?
Well, I wish you were going to throw snow at me.
No, just the height of it.
Wow, they smashed up the light there, huh?
Where did this side go?
Neat, huh?
Right around there in the tower.
How's this one? How's this? See that. Try and walk out.
eventually happened. Did you crash?
No, he banged it somewhere.
Yesterday I ran over it.
I don't think that's it.
Of course, it was this.
Jimmy, go wash your hands.
I fell off and I started again.
Good.
No, okay, go back. Get back there, Caitlin Ann.
Come on, Oklahoma!
second today.
Hey, well, at least you don't have
to. I was thinking there, where he's going, dog. You should have sent us. Come on, send us. And then this week, no, they're going to investigate. So then he jumps the car before he goes.
Yeah.
God, I'm gonna die.
Can I see it?